New to iFIX? Installing iFIX for the first time? Hi, I'm Kathleen. I'm a tech writer here at G Digital, and I'm going to walk you through the installation process. iFIX is supported on the following Windows operating systems. In this video, we're going to be installing iFIX on a Windows Server 2019. For more information on other system requirements, go to our documentation homepage, www.ge.com/digital/documentation. You're going to click iFIX and then important product information and then system requirements. And you can see them right here. Next, before you begin, you're going to log into your computer as administrator, that you aren't logged in via RDP or a terminal server session, and then make sure there are no other GE processes running. Now let's get started. Run the product install. So click the install iFIX 6.5. This new message appears to let you know about the new secure mode. So we're just going to click yes to proceed. On the welcome screen, you're going to click next. Click accept and then next to continue. And now you're going to select the type of iFIX install. I'm going to select typical and then click next. And then you're going to leave the default path here and then click next. And then finally click install. Now several screens will appear as the install progresses. So just hang out here for a little bit. Some of the key new features that you get from iFIX 6.5 include Configuration Hub, which is a new tool that lets you configure your HMI SCADA products from a web browser, enhanced security, and a new sample system. So after a few minutes, you're going to get this firewall setting message. So you're just going to click yes to enable iFIX through the Windows firewall. And then this new Configuration Hub install screen. In this example, I'm going to select to install and register the local instance of Configuration Hub to install Config Hub on the server. So it's all on the same machine. And now I'm going to enter a client ID and a client secret. So here are a few things to keep in mind with the client secret. And really important, be sure to take note of these values that you enter in these fields. You'll later need these when you install Historian, or if you want to change the Config Hub server location, for instance. So click Install again to continue. And after the install and registration completes, this dialog box appears. I'm going to select SCADA and Standalone, and then OK. You could later change these values in the SCU after the install completes, so don't worry too much if you make a mistake here. Now, this is another new screen in the iFIX install. We're just going to leave the defaults in this dialog box and let iFIX add my currently logged in user to this group. And I'm going to choose not to run iFIX as a service, so I'm going to leave this option cleared too. But if I wanted to run iFIX as a service, I would enter the information here. But I could go back and change this later. So click OK, and then choose whether you want to read the release notes and reboot your computer. As a reminder, we're not going to do this now, but you could add other Windows users who will need to use or operate iFIX to that Windows group that we specified at the end of the install. After you restart your computer, go up to the support website and check for any updates. So on digitalsupport.ge.com, you're going to go to the iFIX product download page right here. And then you'll see what updates are available. Now, for security purposes, it's really important that you go back and change those default usernames and passwords. So in the iFIX workspace, on the application tab, click security and then security configuration utility. And then next, click the users button. Click guest user and then modify. This opens the user profile dialog box. So you're going to change the default username and password here and then click OK. Next, click the system administrator user, and then modify, and then do the same thing. Click OK to finish. Save and exit the app. Now, as a final step, you may need to update the Windows host file. This file assists Windows in resolving host names with their IP addresses. This isn't a step that everyone has to do. It really depends upon your setup. From Windows Explorer, you can find the host file in the Windows/System32/Drivers/ETC folder. So you're just going to add the IP address and the computer name here, like this, and then save the file. This concludes our walkthrough. Thank you for watching.